Hello and welcome back to Farming Simulator Goldcrest Valley, episode 6. As you can see, we're in early summer now, and I have some new additions to the farm. I've just purchased this Joshkin Liquitrans 8000. This is a mod. I got it in blue, as it is going to be a water driller, and possibly other liquids too if we so need it. And one of the other things that I have done off camera is I've cleared the rest of the trees from this row of grass and just moved the wood over here. I've not chopped it up, I've just moved it out of the way. I was thinking might leave it whole for better processing. I have also leased this Portlinger lawnmower. I have it on the back of the fence here, as today we are going to cut this grass in preparation for getting sheep. So we will crack on ahead with that just now. I have obviously positioned this tractor ready to make a start. Also managed to get crop destruction turned back on. For some reason that stopped working in the last couple of days. I have also removed the stumps, as you can see from the crop destruction we have on the grass there. So the plan for today is to get this area of grass here cut and baled, some of it baled anyway. Feeling all of it, obviously. Be happy with one or two bales. Not sure how this will work with a bale mostly full of straw, but I'm sure we'll find out the hard way. So we're on episode 6 now. By episode 8, I plan to have sheep on the go, and by then we'll also be in late summer, so we'll have quite a lot of crops that we have to harvest. That's the plan for the next couple of videos anyway, and obviously I do put some pieces off camera as well, just to keep a bit of momentum going with these videos. I have noticed they do seem to last a little bit longer than I'd like, so I would like to shorten them slightly. Not by too much, but I'm aiming for around the 30 to 45 minute mark would be I think it'll be better. As obviously not everyone can commit to watching almost an hour of footage. This episode will probably be a little bit shorter, although I have said that a couple of times now and it's not been the case. In other news, I have managed to figure out what I was doing wrong when rendering my videos, and I have now started rendering them in full screen, which has obviously fixed the black areas around the videos that I was getting in my first three Farming Simulator videos. And I did figure this out while rendering episode 1 of Euro Truck Simulator. So all of the Euro Truck Simulator footage is rendered properly, and from now on all the Farming Simulator footage will be as well. The last two episodes, I believe, should also be rendered properly. So I'm recording this in advance. Today's footage on the day I'm recording this has already been published, and I've already recorded a video for tomorrow, so I'm actually recording this 2 days in advance. The reason I'm doing that is because I'd like to build a sort of a stack of videos ready to be published, so that I can start recording more of a variety of different videos. The Eurotruck Simulator videos are obviously shorter, so I can produce more of them in a much shorter time frame. So they're not an issue, but the Farming Simulator videos do take quite a long time to record and then render and upload. But hopefully I will be having a second series of Farming Simulator 2017 to add to a playlist just shortly. I've not decided just yet what map I'll be doing, but it will be on a modded map. And it will be slightly different from this series. I intend on there being, rather than an end goal like there is on this series, to make the over £1 million mark. With my next Farming Simulator series on a modded map that I'm yet to design, I plan to have it for a set number of episodes, which I think would be slightly better, knowing how long it's going to take to actually film an entire series. The number I have in mind for that is somewhere in the region of 30 to 40 episodes. I think 30 is a good number to aim for, but not necessarily entirely sure what's going to happen with this build, what type of build it's going to be in. There's into my build. I do have the Round Baler Unloader mod, but I don't think that actually works with this particular baler, which is unfortunate. Not the end of the world, I'll continue to use this baler anyway. I think I will do roughly half of this field as bales. I'll do this outside edge. Then I will put the post ready. Hope to avoid leaving any. As my intention is to make the video shorter, I'm not sure if I should change the time scales so that there is less actual playtime per video, or if I should do 2 episodes per one in-game day. I will figure that out in the next video, I think. But I will leave it at times 15 for now, and see how far we get through the day towards the end of the video, and go from there. If it's not a reasonable amount of video length, then obviously I will make them longer, but at this point it is all trial and error. hopefully there's more trial than error. So this will do things a little bit differently. Cut off through here and get all of these areas here then. I may release a time-lapse video, as I have something in mind to do that I think wouldn't justify a full-length video. I won't leave that as a bit of a secret just now, and come back to it closer to the relevant time. But hopefully it's something that I personally haven't seen any other YouTubers do. It's something I do quite often on my own saves on the default maps from Giants. And so we'll see how that works out. I've never actually done it on this map before. So we'll just have to see how that one plays out. I may not do it, so if I don't do anything dramatic, don't get too upset with it. Oops. Certainly not what I want to do. And that makes it so much better when we do it again with the data. Almost got a complete bail here. Take this little section here. Part of it is I will run that for the next row. Inside of this baler looks like it would be somewhat painful to trap it actually. Medieval torture device. So the ground temperature is 11 Celsius with the ambient temperature being 16 Celsius, so it's quite a warm day. But obviously the three fields that we own are all seeded. I will be looking to buy more fields soon. But we will just see how that plays out. Not sure which fields, but we will be buying more than one, obviously to achieve the goal that we're looking for. We would need to buy quite a few. I would like to do a bit more forestry work soon as well, something I mentioned in a previous video. Not sure when to get around to doing that. Just now my focus is on preparing to have the sheep. So what we'll do now is, that's all the bills that I really need for the time being. So what I'll do is I'll just fill the baler just once more. One more bale out of it. And we will leave the rest of the cut grass as loose grass. Which I will pick up at a later date. As soon as I'm finished this, I will go and have a closer look at the Joskin trailer and fill it with water. It's quite a well-made model. The blue I chose is slightly bright, hopefully not too garish. So, one more partial pass and that will be this baler done. My intention was to leave slightly more than this. Maybe I should have not decided to do this last pass. That is all our baling done for today. So, through here, onto this barn. Swap over to the Massey Ferguson if I've left myself enough room to get out. So it's Massey Ferguson 600 series. This is a very good mod. Very pleased with how this mod is. Although we will most likely upgrade the Fendt at some point. I will probably keep hold of this Massey Ferguson for a couple of reasons. One of them being obviously that it has the front loader attachment on it, and it is a small utility style tractor in my opinion. Seems remote and capable. Just refill the water tank here. Hence the Liquitrans 8000, it takes 8000 litres of water. And what we do now is we also take this up to our sheep pasture. And we'll leave this trailer up there. So as mentioned previously, I do intend on having the sheep in the next episode or two. I'm not quite sure yet on what our second animal will be. Any thoughts on that, let me know, and that is a little bit away yet. So, let me know in the comments what you prefer between cows and pigs. I've got more experience in FS17 with the pigs, and I have a mod from Pig Silo. I'm slightly more comfortable with pigs, but I believe that the cows are roughly the same concept. So, very picturesque view from there. So, this is not a map I've played too heavily on, so I just have a loop. Water fill point is. Slightly dangerous area. I think it'll be one of these. Yeah, over there in front. So I will fill up the water trough as much as I let me, which obviously shouldn't be too terribly much. And park this trailer up somewhere. Anywhere over a convenient floor. And we'll park it next to the wool collection point. I think that would be. Not a mod that you would likely see very often given the amount of park it, but still a fantastic mod all the same. So I'll just make my way back down to the farm. Probably have gone the wrong way again. Seems to be a bit of a habit. Quite a bumper. I'm not expecting that one. The back end of the town here. I'll just head up this way. Field 22 is quite a large field. That would be a very profitable field to own. Not sure of the price of it. But hopefully it's not too much, because it is one that I do intend on purchasing. And probably next year it will be. So by next year I'm referring to the game time and not real life. If I should switch to the Bilford and find out how much the grass grows, it would be just worth. Anything has moved from where I left it. What I will do is use this pavement area here to store my front loader attachments. I'm going to sell the bale that I've decided to try and run away first. See how much money we get from that. I do need to also move these pallets at some point. Obviously, you would have noticed from the top of the video that I did buy the vehicle repair shed. It's a good addition to the farm, it means I can customise my vehicles if I have to go all the way down to the town, which is slightly boring and a bit inconvenient. I'm just going to want to watch me drive back and forth to the town every 2 minutes. This particular front loader attachment is one that will need to be modified. Use a bale for it, but you can customise it to also be a pallet fork as well. Which is quite handy. Did we even get anything from it? I'm not sure that we did. Ferguson build row. It still has our 4 builds on it. But I may sell because we're going to have plenty more. We will have plenty more builds where those ones came from, as all these fields are planted with wheat, so not going to be a shortage of straw. I held on with one bill spike there, hopefully it will not fall off. Move these bills over to the bill shed and leave them there for the time being. That is just wonderful. Yeah, actually, no, you could pick them up from inside. Not worried about organizing them just now. Just move them off the pasture. I do have somewhat of a plan for them. A bit more money first. I'm going to get the bale wrapper for these Cernus silage bales. So for now, I just need them out of the way, off the field, As soon as the field regrows, I will cut it down. And I won't show that on camera. But I'm going to purchase the bale storage barn mod, which I believe I downloaded today. So I'll be able to store these bales away nicely, unlike that. I'm not getting it in the shed. I do realise I do have some equipment that is not necessarily needed at the time. I'm not kind of sure if I should sell that and get some of the money back for it, or if I should leave it as it is. I'll just drive through here. Slightly more money for me this time, I believe. Usual way of strapping there, so it's a bit of a gap towards the end. But what I will do with this trailer is I will park it in the main farm for Penguin. I'll just park it over here because we'll actually be needing this in an episode of 3. I would say or 2, but I've kind of filled my schedule for the next 2 episodes. I'm not sure if that trailer I have is one that you can put grass into. That is not what I wanted to take off. That's the wrong button. Due to the back, I should be able to pick up the grass with a shovel. I'm just going to pick up some of the grass just now. I also noticed earlier that I could have bought the Massey Ferguson log handler attachment, which would have made life quite a lot easier. It's just a little bit of a dip there that I'm not quite getting into. It's not what I wanted to do. Failing dramatically. Try coming at it from another angle to show. Oh, look, it's just slightly too low from there. To get a bit more grass than we have. Well, it seems pointless putting in the trail at this point. But I will give that a go anyway, see if that's something I can do. So I could then come at it from where I'm at right now. This one will probably do the exact same. We missed the end of it there. I 99%. It never seems to be able to get to that 100%. Crashed right into our brand new combo. Not something you want to do. Take the trailer out of the shed. Get this food quickly tidied away. Plenty of dips to go through in this field. Is fully completed. Wonder if I'll ever be able to make it through an entire video without crashing this front loader into something. Would be nice to see. Just gonna collect our trailer with my better of the two tractors. It's the more powerful and faster tractor. So I personally prefer using for most tasks. I do like this tractor. I'm hoping to actually upgrade at some point to class tractor. That would make a nice addition to the farm. That will be a little while before I can afford that yet. It's not the cheapest tractors that are for sale. But they are certainly some of the better tractors that are for sale. Come down through this cell bay. Around field 11 here, it's quite a large field. This would make an ideal grass field. Keep the sheep in a plentiful supply of grass. Points of interest over here. I will just bring my trailer around here. Not sure if I have enough room to and at that point, not an awful lot of grass. Just made it by that tree there. What I will do is pull forward a little bit. And I will unload the rest of the grass here. That was when I was swallowed out. So now, in theory at least, our sheep are ready to purchase. Which we will be doing on the next episode. And we have made it to the end of the more or less, this video is around the 40 minute mark. Roughly. I have a recording timer earlier on my screen, but by the time that I started roughly to now, it's in the region of 40 minutes. So I will take the tractor back to the farm. Interested in how everyone is enjoying the series. So if you are enjoying the series, please leave a thumbs up or a comment and let me know what you're enjoying. If you're not enjoying the series, so leave a thumbs down and leave a comment let me know why, so I know what I can improve upon. Can I fix an issue that I don't know about? So if there's something you'd like to see me do differently, or something you're not happy about, let me know and I'll do my best to change it. But that is all for today's video. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.